Hi everybody, thank you for tuning in to check out this video, and today I will be showing y'all how to install an addressable device on the SK-6808. So let's go ahead and get started. Now today I'm going to be installing my other heat detector. I mean, I know I have one up there already, but I'm just going to go ahead and install this one. That way y'all can find out how to add an addressable device to your SK-6000 panel. First things first, what we're gonna do is, before we do anything, we have to power down the panel. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Now we have to open the batteries. All right, the panel's now powered down. Now we're gonna go ahead and go over to where we're gonna mount our heat detector. All right, we're at the spot where we're gonna mount our heat detector, which is right here. All right, there we see we got our base mounted. Now, just gonna go ahead and connect the wires. So first what we're gonna do is we're gonna connect the positive right wires here and the negative wires right here. Get this screwed in. Now for the negative wires. All right, I'm gonna have to put the camera down to get the negative wires wired, and I'll get right back to y'all. All right, everything's wired in nice and secure. And now we're just gonna go ahead and set the address of our detector head. I'll have a smoke detector right here. This will be detector address number 3, so we're gonna set this one to detector address number 4. As you can see, this is the tens, which we're not gonna leave alone. We're gonna turn the right dial right up address number 4. I'm gonna have to put the camera down again to do this, because this is kind of hard to do with one hand. All right, so see, we got our detector head set at address number 4. Now, what we're gonna do is put the detector head right onto our base. And there it is. Now what we gotta do is we gotta power up the panel. I'll meet y'all back over at the panel. All right, we're back at the panel. Now we're just gonna go ahead and power the panel back up again. All right, I got the panel powered back up. So we're gonna go ahead and wait for the SLC to initialize, and I'll show y'all what will happen. And you see we got a system trouble because we have an unused SLC device on the circuit. And that's also because we have not programmed it. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. The next device, I'll show y'all how to program over the software, but today I'll show you how to do it right on the keypad. Back out. Now we're gonna go to enter, go to the login, go to users, and enter the passcode, which I cannot show y'all. All right. We're gonna go to number 7, which is panel programming. And we're gonna go down to point, the internal SLC. We're gonna set this as sensor, set our heat detector as sensor number 4. And we're going to set this to zone 2, which is our detector zone, and we don't have any accessory base. So we're going to go ahead and save the changes, and we're going to go ahead and back out. Now we're just going to go wait for the panel to reset, and we're going to go back over to the heat detector. All right, we're back at the heat detector. Now we just gotta wait for the LEDs to light up and start blinking. So I'm just gonna give it a few seconds. See, there we go. The LEDs have lit up. It means the SLC is initializing, and this will take about 30 seconds. So I'm going to cut the camera, and I'll get right back to y'all when it's finished initializing. All right, it's now it's blinking, which means our heat detector is now functioning. So all that's left to do is to test it out, see if it works. I'm going to go ahead and get my testing tool, and I'll get right back to y'all. All right, I got my little magnet testing tool. So all we're going to do is going to hold the magnet up to the sensor, and the LEDs will turn steady red. Here we go. Let's give it a test in 3, 2, 1. There we go. And you see, the voice vac is turned off because it's late at night, so only the strobe is. So you see the LEDs on the detector have turned red. So now we gotta go over and silence the panel. And to reset the heat detector, all we're gonna do is we're gonna press system reset. All right, and before I conclude the video, we'll go ahead and activate it using the rate of rise method, which is my hairdryer. So I'm just gonna point my hairdryer up to the detector. It's gonna take about 45 seconds and it'll go ahead and activate. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and test the heat detector with the rate of rise. Here we go, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Again, it takes about 45 seconds to a minute for it to activate with the rate of rise. So I do apologize about that, but as you can see, our detector is activated again. We're gonna go back over to the panel and silence it again. So we're gonna wait about a minute before we reset the system to make sure that the detector has cooled back down enough. Otherwise, if I reset it now, highly likely that the detector will reactivate again, which will put the panel back into alarm. So I'll get right back to y'all in just a minute. All right, now I think it's cooled down enough now. We're just gonna go ahead and hit system reset on the panel. All right, our system's now reset and the detector has cooled down enough, so it's starting to blink green again. And that's how you add an addressable device via the keypad on your SK-6000 panel. All right, everybody. Thank y'all for watching this video. Be sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. Have a great day, and I will see y'all in the next video.